click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know that is what is pH and what is pOH. We have that is defined the pH as well as pOH, and we have made a formula for that also, or an expression, a mathematical expression for that. And related to that only, we are going to make a relationship between pH and pOH. So what is the relation between these two? Let us talk about it. So now, before understanding that is what is the relation between pH and pOH, in the previous lecture we have also discussed about the ionic product of water. So that is the reason that we are going to talk about the ionic product of water, because that is water is the only substance which consists of H plus and OH minus ion in equal proportion, and that is the reason that we are now talking about the ionic product of water. So in this case we have got to know that is for ionic product of water, or whenever a water gets dissociated into this form, that is H2, and that on dissociation that will give that is H plus ion along with that of the OH minus ion. And if we apply the law of mass action, and in that case we have got to know that is Kw is the one which is nothing but the it is the product of that is H plus ion concentration as well as that is OH minus ion concentration. So this is nothing known as ionic product of water. But it has been also found that the concentration or the product of the concentration of H plus ion along with that of the OH minus ion, it is nothing but that is 1.0 into 10 raised to minus 14. But at a particular temperature, and that temperature was that is at 298 Kelvin. So this is the expression that we have got in the ionic product of water, and by using this only we are going to make a relationship between that is pH and pOH. So let us do this one. So this is what we have, that is we have that is H plus ion along with that of the OH minus ion, and we can also write it at in this form, that is 10 raised to minus 14. But what if we apply log on both the side? So therefore, if we apply log on both the side, because this is the multiplication that we have, so therefore we could say that this could be turned into this form, that is log of H plus, because this is multiplication, so therefore I will write it here as plus log of OH minus ion, and we would also apply the log to this one, that is log of that is I would name it as 10 raised to minus 14. So let us see what is the thing that we could get over here. So therefore by applying this thing we could get that is log of H plus plus log of OH minus ion, and that could be written as that is minus 14 log of 10, and log of 10 is nothing but 1, so therefore we could write it in this form also, that is minus 14, and in this case this would be basically log of H plus plus log of OH minus. So this whole equation that we have made it over here, we can also write it in this form, where the means we are multiplying it by minus 1. So suppose if we multiply this by minus 1, then what we could get? We could get that is minus log of H plus minus log of that is OH minus, and ultimately minus into minus, that is basically 14. So in fact we could write the above equation in this format also. So now this will help us out to make a relation. As you could see, it is the similar terms that we have did in our previous lecture, that is in terms of pH and pOH. I'll help you out how to do. So therefore we could write the previous equation in this form, that is minus log of that is H plus ion plus, I could write it in this form, that is minus log of concentration of OH minus ion, which was equals to 14. But if you know the term that is pH, about pH or the definition of pH, and in that case we have got to know that is pH is nothing but the negative log to the base 10 of the H plus ion concentration. While talking about the pOH, it is nothing but the negative log to the base 10 of the OH minus ion concentration. So that is the reason this term can be written as pH, and this is the plus that we have, and this term can be written as pOH, and this is the 14 that we have. So now this makes a relationship between pH and pOH, and that is basically 14. So this is what the relationship between pH and pOH is, and based on this thing, we could easily calculate, suppose if we know a particular pH value for a particular acid or for a particular solution. So therefore, on that basis, we could easily calculate that what would be the pH value of that particular solution, or vice versa, if you know the value of pOH, and based on this thing, we could easily calculate that what would the pH value of that particular solution. So this is the relation between that, and we could easily get the values over here. But talking about this thing, that is a term that has been involved, that is in this case, is whether we should measure a particular solution's acidity or basicity based on which content. Means can we make it with the help of pH, or can we make it with the help of pOH? So that is the thing that we are going to study about, and that is basically known as pH scale. So pH scale is nothing but it ranges from, that is usually it ranges from 0 to 14, and in which case basically 0 to 7 is the one which is showcasing that the particular solution is acidic in nature, while the one which is basically showing from 14 to 7, it shows that it is the solution would be basic in nature, and when the pH is basically 7, it is 7, then it indicates that that particular solution is neutral. So that is the reason that pH scale is very important for us to determine whether the particular solution is acidic or basic. And in spite of that, it also gives us the strength or the concentration of the H plus ion that will be present in the solution. And based on that thing, we could easily determine various concepts like acid, base, or the concentration of H plus ion and the concentration of OH minus ion. So meanwhile, talking about this one, that is, we have made a relationship between pH and pOH, and that's it. I wanted to explain you. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. And I hope you will share this video with friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.